Hi, my name is Nathan Beard, and I am the instructor of Wetland to Studio, a class I teach at Dunedin Fine Art Center on Saturday mornings. And I'm just so pleased that all of, or a portion of my students, I should say, for the past 3 years, have agreed to show their work here at City Hall in Dunedin. It's a really interesting collection, and it's fun to see everyone's different approach of the same subject matter. The Wetland to Studio class is a sort of hybrid between abstraction and representation, and we explore a lot of more abstract painting techniques. We use turkey basters, syringes, spoons, anything that can scrape, pour, splatter, and put paint on other than a brush and a palette knife. We try to explore those things to make textures and marks and sort of replicate the chaos of nature and how it constructs itself, while also utilizing our artistic knowledge to order it in a way for ourselves. So it makes sense of it for ourselves. So it's a fun process. We take photos at Hammock Park here in Dunedin. That's where we start the class. And then we go through some exercises where we learn to sort of see our photographs in an abstract way. For example, looking at sticks as lines, or looking, instead of looking at leaves as leaves, we look at them as splotches or dots or something like that. Each student is free to bring their own background and experience level and technique to the class. So really, the bulk of the class is spent on trying to remain adventurous as you progress through the painting experience.
Hi, I'm Linda, and I took Nathan Beard's class at Dunedin Fine Arts. It was a bit out of my comfort zone, as I've never done this type of painting before, and kind of new to painting itself. Why I picked the swamp lilies was that I have volunteered at Botanical Gardens in Largo for about 20 years, and we planted some of these swamp lilies along the pond there. And so it kind of brought back memories, and I felt very close to it.
My name is Colleen Baxter. I'm the artist of this piece. It's called Swamp Reflections, number 3. I painted it while I was taking a class with Nathan Beard, his Wetlands to Studio class. I took his class. I was inspired to take his class because I felt like I needed to be more free with my painting and more impressionistic and less detailed. And I feel like I got that out of his class. I enjoyed Nathan, the way he teaches the class and the class itself.
My name is Diane Clement. This painting is called Hammock Layers. And I did it 2 years ago, just before the shutdown, and I got to experience Nathan's wonderful class and take all of those wonderful techniques with me into the 2 years that I was kind of in my studio a lot. This painting is a mixed media piece, and one of the things that I learned so much from Nathan's class is about, I just got so much more freedom. He had us put panties on the floor and use a lot of body movement and use a lot of different tools instead of just a paintbrush, and it was wonderful. And other thing that I, as I reflected on this, is that I loved what I learned about the way that I could achieve depth in a different way. Layers of gloss medium, and it just was a wonderful.
My name is Monica Sword. I'm an artist and writer and traveler living here in Dunedin. Art always fascinated me, even from childhood, but it wasn't until I was transitioning from an information technology that I got more serious about making art. That was about 15 years ago. But a few years ago, I was one of the first students to take Nathan Beard's Wetland a Studio class. And he helped me understand that there was a lot more going on that I realized when looking at a composition in nature. So I was very challenged with looking at the layers of a calm waterway and translating that onto a two-dimensional surface. But I really love challenges, and I love taking Nathan's class.
My name is Mary Louise Pollock. I received a degree in fashion design and illustration from Florida State University and went on to have a family and years later joined the crew at Dunedin Fine Art Center. Recently, I took Nathan's class and I really enjoyed it. This is a product of one of my pieces that I did. It's called Reflections, and as his class works through, you take a photograph on or near water, and then you get to have fun with it. So I really enjoyed the class and had a great time doing it.
My name is Valerie Hart, and this name of the painting is Blue Shadow. It was a very freeing experience because of the size of the canvas, which is one that I had not necessarily worked with. And it's a combination, it was a combination for me of connecting with community and a form of painting that is full of expression and movement, and at the same time narrowing in on photos that we had taken at Hammock Park. So it was a sort of close look, no horizon obviously. At the same time, the way of painting it was big strokes, big canvas, form of expression. It was, the whole experience was really sort of delightful. And this piece, for me, represents sort of a chaos as well as a calmness at the same time.
Hi, my name is Diane B. Radel. And I started painting after my 60th birthday in a primordial moment on the beach. My main series of paintings is abstracts of these turtle tracks that I find. So I wanted to take this class because it's a completely different way of working for me. Instead of sketching something out in a little tiny brush, I'm laying a canvas on the floor and loading it with watered down paint in a turkey baster and splashing on to suggest the layers. And it took me a while to get the hang of it because it was so different. But once I got the freedom down and like, okay, it doesn't have to look like anything special. You just are suggesting the layers. So I was able to, and then Nathan, of course, would, you know, showed us like how he works, and which is like the class in itself. But you know, you're just putting marks and things and just layer by layer to layer to suggest looking down into the water at the park.
Good morning, I'm Sue Beach, and I am originally from Buffalo, New York. I now live down here in Spring Hill, Florida, and I'm enjoying being very active in many organizations in the Dunedin area. And I am primarily a watercolorist, and so for me, this I would liken this technique to that of Vita Engel, a watercolorist that I really admire a lot, in that she likes to let the watercolor paint itself, and she puts a lot of different watery layers down and then goes back and adds some thicker layers. Watercolor is a little different than acrylic in the way that you apply it, but I approach this like a watercolor painting in that I put down real transparent layers first and then translucent and then opaque. And so I really enjoyed working on this in Nathan Beard's class. It forced me to loosen up quite a bit. I tend to be, I was trained as a photorealist. I'm a retired art teacher. And so even when I was teaching, my students tended to prefer doing photorealist and realist works of art. So this was a great experience for me because it forced me to loosen up a lot and not be real specific in the beginning. And like Diane had said, we started out with turkey basters loaded with watery paint and throwing the paint around, similar to Nita Engel when she does her watercolor paintings. And then we took our photo resources and tried to be a little bit more specific, and talk about the different types of plants and trees and flowers that we might see in the Dunedin area. And so it was a process that I really enjoyed. It forced me to loosen up and be someone that was a little bit more objective rather than subjective. So it was a wonderful experience.
My name is Marilyn Washaleski, and I painted this in Nathan Beard's class because I was intrigued by his process. And I've always considered myself an experimental artist, and I use many different types of media, mixed media, acrylic, watercolor. And I always admired Nathan's ability to create paintings that were ethereal in nature. And so when his class opened up, I jumped in to Dunedin Fine Art Center, where I had never taken a class before. And I just enjoyed the freeing process of having the canvas initially laid on the floor and throwing paint on it to see what would happen. And then building up layers at that point to create, from photos we had taken at Hammock Park, pieces that reflected light, reflected the sky and the water, reflected the land, and just still resulted in an abstract piece which had lots and lots of ethereal kinds of feeling to it.
I'm Ellen Dargan Knapp, and I've really enjoyed this. The classes I've taken multiple with Nathan, and it was sort of like a perfect place for me. When I did come to Nathan's class, I was just, it was perfect. It was just so exciting.
Part of the Wetland Studio class is painting large, and for many students it's their first time painting large. So in the end, what we hope to instill in the each artist is a sense of adventure and curiosity in their painting. And also quite a bit of the process is getting over fears of you know, not being a perfect drawer or not being a perfect painter or anything that, and really just having a lot of fun. I think what's really cool about this show is how it connects the arts to the parks that we have in our area, state parks, local parks, and then specifically Hammock Park here in Dunedin, and the healing and the sort of respite that we find in nature and in art, and how they're so connected, and that the sort of sorting through the messiness of nature and finding something that's beautiful, pleasurable, and that resonates with each person's individual